Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on fuel injector failure and some common causes, symptoms, and diagnostics. Little background information before diving into some of the symptoms, causes, and fixes for fuel injector failure. Fuel injectors are a critical component in internal combustion engines, and they are exposed to a significant amount of abuse and wear and tear over the years. In a typical gasoline engine in any vehicles, injectors can fire up to 50 or 60 times per second, or even more than that, which ultimately means over the lifetime of the fuel injectors, they can easily fire several hundred million times. So again, just a lot of abuse and wear and tear. So it's easy to see and understand why fuel injectors do run into issues frequently and often need replacement and repairs, especially as vehicles get older and past that 100,000 mile ballpark. When it comes to fuel injector failures and issues, there are really a couple different primary causes of these issues. Number one, as I kind of already addressed, there is just standard wear and tear. They do take a lot of abuse over the years, so they can just wear down naturally and eventually start running into issues because of that. But a few common causes that may lead to injector failure include fuel contamination. Often this can lead to issues with clogged fuel injectors. There's also issues with water in fuel. Water is very corrosive, so that can start corroding the fuel injectors if you do have excess water in your fuel system, which is especially common if you do run ethanol or E85 in your vehicle, as ethanol contains a lot more water and can be very corrosive to the fuel system and injectors. And then lastly, there are the fuel injector seals, which can ultimately lead to leaking fuel injectors, and that can occasionally be external to the engine or actually leaking outside from the injectors, or it could be leaking into the actual cylinder itself. Now, moving on to some of the most common signs and symptoms of fuel injector failure, we have misfires, rough idle or bouncing RPM, especially while at idle, power loss, stuttering, hesitation, poor fuel economy, raw unburnt fuel smell, which is especially common with leaking fuel injectors, and then a check engine light illuminated as well as fault codes stored in the car's computer. Now, a lot of the times the actual fault codes that will be stored, rather than being related directly to an injector, a lot of the times it will point to other issues. Again, the misfires or air to fuel ratios that can be incorrect due to leaking or clogged fuel injectors. So often you'll get some diagnostic trouble codes that may not be directly pointing you to the fuel injector, but can indicate that there may be a fuel injector issue on hand. Fuel injector failure is a very serious issue, and it is important to diagnose and fix things in a timely manner. There are a lot of potential longevity and long-term reliability concerns when it comes to problems with the fuel injectors. So a couple examples of that, if you do have a leaking fuel injector that is actually leaking fuel into the cylinders, if that's allowed to happen over extended periods of time, what ultimately happens is that extra fuel leaking into the cylinder can wipe oil off of cylinder walls. It can dilute the engine oil with fuel, which obviously reduces lubrication. So ultimately can cause a lot of additional wear and tear and stress on the internal engine components if you do have leaking fuel injectors. They can also damage catalytic converters, oxygen sensors, and other parts. And then additionally, other various types of fuel injector issues. For example, if you have a clogged injector, it might still be flowing a little bit of fuel, but not quite enough, which means that you then have a cylinder that is running very lean, which exposes the engine and puts it at greater risk of running into engine knock and detonation, which, much like the oil dilution and fuel wiping oil off cylinder walls, this just causes premature wear and a lot of extra stress on the internal engine components. So ultimately, again, fuel injector failure is something that is pretty serious and should be diagnosed and repaired as soon as possible, not only due to the number of short-term symptoms and drivability issues that you may experience, but also because some of these long-term reliability concerns that can arise from having issues with your fuel injectors. Moving on to diagnosing a faulty fuel injector, there are really a couple different steps here, but as always, when you are diagnosing any problem with a vehicle, really the best starting point is just having a simple OBD2 scanner and actually pulling any stored diagnostic trouble codes from the car's computer. This will often point you in the right direction. For example, when you have fuel injector issues, you'll almost always have a misfire from the cylinder that is having injector issues. And so you can use that code, for example, like a P0303 code, to know that you are having issues with cylinder number 3 specifically, and that can help point you in the right direction for where to start and how to start diagnosing any issues with the fuel injectors. Once you've identified the codes and suspect that you do have issues with your fuel injectors, at this point there are multiple ways to actually test and figure out which injectors are problematic and confirming that they actually are problematic. So number one, once you use the OBD2 scanner, let's say that you notice you had fault code P0301, which would indicate a cylinder 1 misfire. You can then try swapping the cylinder 1 fuel injector with a cylinder that isn't having issues. So let's say cylinder number 2 is totally fine. You're not getting any misfires or any problems with cylinder 2. You can just try swapping those two fuel injectors and then retesting, clearing the codes, waiting for them to come back to see if that misfire did actually follow to the new cylinder. If it remains on cylinder 1, then that means the injector in all likelihood was working fine, since it's now on cylinder 2 and you aren't getting any issues over there now. So that may point you in a different direction that it isn't actually the fuel injector itself experiencing issues. Or on the other hand, once you swap those injectors, if suddenly the misfire follows and moves from cylinder 1 to cylinder 2, then that's likely a pretty good giveaway that you are having issues with that fuel injector. Another thing you can try doing is while the engine is running, you can try unplugging the fuel injectors individually. So when you do unplug the fuel injector, at that point you should hear a noticeable drop in RPMs and really a very different engine sound due to the misfire, since if you unplug the injector, it won't be flowing any fuel and won't be firing at all. So that should lead to misfires in a different engine note and just a different sound from the engine. Now, if you go to unplug that injector and nothing happens, the engine sounds exactly the same, then in all likelihood, that fuel injector is having issues and already wasn't firing, and that's why you're not hearing any sound changes when you actually unplugged it. A couple easy ways to test there. Now, there are a couple additional tests you can do. However, they will require some additional tools and a little bit of extra work. For example, you can use a multimeter to test the ohms of the injectors to make sure everything is running properly there. And there are some other tests and tools that you can use. But again, it will be slightly more advanced and require some additional equipment. So really, the first two things I discussed are going to be the easiest ways, with unplugging the injectors or trying to swap the injectors between good and bad cylinders to see if the misfires and issues follow to the new cylinder. Those are really gonna be the easiest things to try at home if you don't have any additional tools or equipment. If you aren't able to identify anything, then at that point, you're likely best off going to a repair shop and getting the problem fixed in a timely manner, since again, fuel injector issues can be very serious and lead to other reliability and longevity concerns with the engine. In summary, again, fuel injectors just take a lot of abuse and a lot of wear and tear over the years and mileage. So it's something that naturally a lot of engines and vehicles start having fuel injector problems, especially once they make it past the 100, 150,000 mile ballpark. Fuel injector issues become much more common. Few of those causes can be contaminated fuel, water in your fuel, or just seals wearing down over time and causing the injectors to begin leaking. Ultimately, that leads to a myriad of different symptoms, and drivability issues can occur with fuel injector problems, since with improper air fuel mixtures, you can get all sorts of different issues ranging from misfires to rough idle, power loss, stuttering, hesitation, so on so forth. Diagnostics are generally pretty simple, especially with an OBD2 scanner. Just locate the injector or the cylinder that is having issues with the injector. Try unplugging it, see if you hear any different sounds from the engine or if it remains the same, or try swapping the injector with a good cylinder. Couple easy ways to diagnose the issue. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, guys.